We want to find the sum. So if you want to find the sum, this says add things up. That's what the symbol says. And this part here is the general term. So it'll generate all the terms for you. And then this tells you to start plugging in 1, in for I, and keep plugging in, going up by 1s, until you get to 5. So it looks like there'll be 5 terms. Let's do the first term. So let's plug I equals 1. So that'll be, that'll give me 3 times 4 to the 1. 4 to the 1 is 4, 4 times 3 will be 12. So my first term is 12. Maybe I'll put it up here. 12 plus, let's do the second term. So that's when I is equal to 2. So 3 times 4 squared. 4 squared is 16 times 3 is 48. That'll be my next term. Okay, let's do I equals 3. 3 times 4 cubed. 4 cubed, 4 is 64 times 3. 12, 1, 192. So this is 192 plus 192. Now I could keep going, or I can establish what the pattern is and then just use the sum formula. It's actually nice to do always. So you could get the fourth one and the fifth one, figure out what those are, and then just add up all those numbers. Or, since you know it's a geometric sequence, and I guess we don't know yet, if I go 48 divided by 12 to find the ratio, 48 divided by 12 is 4. And just to confirm, let's go 192 divided by 48. If both those give me a 4, and I think they both do, then I know it's a geometric sequence or series, and I can use this formula. The sum is equal to A1, 1 minus R to the n, all over 1 minus R. So the first term is 12, 1 minus, the ratio is 4, and there's 5 terms, so 4 to the 5th, all over 1 minus, the ratio is 4. Plug that in your calculator, and you should come up here with the same answer as you would come up here if you added all 5 of those terms up together. So that helps you with that question.